Hello. The topic we are discussing today is nature and scope of social psychology. The objectives of this module are: after reading this chapter, you will be able to answer the following questions as to what is social psychology, how did it develop, its growth and integration, is social psychology a Western product, what are the core concerns of the subject, is it a science, and what is its relation to other fields of psychology. Social psychology can be defined as the systematic study of the nature and causes of human social behavior. Let us look at certain features of this definition. First, it states that the main focus of social psychology is human social behavior. This includes the activities of individuals in the presence of others, the processes of social interaction between two or more persons, the relationships between individuals and the groups to which they belong to. Second feature of the definition states that social psychology addresses not only the nature of social behavior, but also the causes of such behavior. Social psychologists seek to discover the preconditions that cause various social behaviors. Causal relations among variables are important building blocks of theory. In turn, theory is crucial for prediction and control of such behavior. Third feature of the definition indicates that social psychologists study social behavior in a very systematic fashion. They rely on formal research methodologies, including experimentation, structured observation, and sample surveys. Thus, social psychology seeks an understanding of the reasons people act the way they do in social situations. Such an understanding helps us explain events in one's own life. For example, the successful job interview, the loneliness of being the new kid in the school, the hesitation that we feel before making a major decision. It also helps us comprehend the factors that contribute to complex events of our time. For example, it helps us to understand about crime and violence, ethnic unrest and civil war, the spread of AIDS as an epidemic, the destruction of the global environment. An understanding of how people are influenced by social and cognitive processes helps us in developing solutions for such pressing social problems. For example, knowing that stereotypes and prejudices about members of other religious groups may contribute to violent conflict suggests that changing these beliefs might help in preventing reoccurrences. Social psychological research has been instrumental in exposing workplace discrimination, to improve classroom environments for minorities and women, in finding ways to change perceptions of the risk of AIDS and other problems. Thus, the social psychological perspective invites us not only to understand but also to act on that understanding. Since the time of ancient Greeks, the study of human condition was thought to be the domain of philosophy. Early philosophers recognized that other people can have an impact on individual behavior. Plato, for example, speculated about the crowd mind, arguing that even the wisest individuals, if assembled into a crowd, might be transformed into an irrational mob. Likewise, philosophers continued to theorize about the workings of human mind, but the development of social psychology took place after the emergence of the science of psychology. The experimental investigation of related issues began in North America, Britain, and France, as researchers began to systematically measure how behavior is influenced by the presence of others. Norman Triplett, an American researcher, is sometimes cited as the first researcher in the field of social psychology. After a few interesting observations, he asked school children to wind fishing line onto reels as quickly as possible in two conditions, where one condition was with the presence of others, secondly, without the presence of others. He observed that children's performance improved in the presence of others. Likewise, early researchers tackled questions about how facial expressions and body movements reveal people's feelings, how people conform to the suggestion of others, and how the roles that experimenters might play in influencing the outcomes of research. One person who has had the most impact on development of social psychology was Adolf Hitler. As German domination spread across Europe in 1930s, a number of psychologists fled Europe to settle in North America. Trained in Gestalt theory, these psychologists from Europe and researchers interacted with American behaviorists, anthropologists, and they soon developed techniques to perform realistic studies of complex social influences in the laboratory. Revelations about Nazi genocide led a horrified world to ask questions about the roots of prejudice and murderous hatred towards Jews, gypsies, homosexuals, and members of other communities. Conditions created by the Second World War also led researchers to search for solutions to immediate practical problems such as eating habits of civilians, maintaining the morale of the military troops, and improving performance of the aircraft crews. Kurt Lewin, one of the pioneers of social psychology, sums up two themes of social psychology. The first one is, people's subjective interpretation of reality is the key determinant of their beliefs and behaviors. Secondly, social structure influences those interpretations and behaviors. During the 1950s and 60s, social psychology grew and flourished, moving towards an integrated theoretical understanding of social and cognitive processes. Furthermore, social psychological research and theory was applied to important practical problems. Research contributions during this period laid the foundation of key topics within social psychology, such as self-esteem, prejudice and stereotyping, conformity, persuasion and attitude change, impression formation, interpersonal attraction, intimate relationships, and intergroup relations. The study of cognitive processes became a natural framework for integration both within and outside social psychology. Cognitive themes such as the importance of people's interpretation in shaping their reactions to events were familiar to social psychologists. Concepts such as attitudes, norms, and beliefs began to be applied to new areas of study such as personal relationships, aggression and altruism, stereotyping and discrimination. Today, researchers in all domains of social psychology are weaving together the effects of cognitive and social processes to provide explanations of people's experience and behavior. Basic science was also integrated with social problems. Because virtually all social psychological research is relevant to significant social issues, it is simultaneously basic and applied. The same underlying social and cognitive processes operate wherever people perceive, influence, and interact with each other, both inside the research laboratory and outside it, be it in schools, factories, courtrooms, playgrounds, or neighborhoods. The enormous volumes of research in social psychology, especially in the United States, have created this misconception that the genesis and nature of social psychology is all American. This has led to the assumption that Asian countries and others are prone to follow research findings of the West, which has created a skewed conceptual and methodological basis for the social psychology. Thus, multifarious roots of the subject in these countries were ignored. Unfortunately, social psychology research in India has been mostly emulative of the West in the past. However, according to Sinha in 1998, in India, the indigenization of psychology is taking firm root and is also a character distinctive from that of the West. Indian social psychologists emphasize the functional interrelatedness of the self, relationships, the society and the universe in the development of identities. It was observed that among Asian social psychologists, there has been a growing awareness and appreciation of cultural identities that are distinct from the Western ones. In modern times, there are researchers who are making serious efforts to realign their understanding to their own social-cultural contexts. There are four core concerns or major themes within social psychology. The first one is the impact that one individual has on another. Second one, the impact that a group has on its individual members. Thirdly, the impact that individual members have on the groups to which they belong to. And fourthly, the impact that one group has on another group. First, let us look at the impact of individuals on individuals. In everyday life, communication from others may significantly influence a person's understanding of the social world. Attempts by others at persuasion may change an individual's belief about the world and his or her attitudes towards persons, groups, and other objects. The outcomes obtained by individuals in everyday life are often affected by the actions of others. Also relevant are various interpersonal sentiments. One individual may develop strong attitudes towards another, for example, liking, disliking, hating the other person, based on who the other person is and what he or she does. Social psychologists investigate these issues to discover why individuals develop positive attitudes towards some and negative attitudes to few others. The second core concern of the subject is the impact of groups on individuals. Individuals belong to many different groups such as families, work groups, seminars and clubs, and therefore they spend many hours each week interacting with these group members. Groups influence and regulate the behavior of their members, typically by establishing norms or rules. One result of this is conformity. Conformity is the process by which a group member adjusts his or her behavior to bring it into line with group norms. Groups also exert substantial long-term influence on their members through a process called socialization. Socialization is a process that enables groups to regulate what their members learn. Socialization assumes that the members will be adequately trained to play roles in the group and in the larger society. Socialization also shapes the knowledge, values, and skills of the group members. There are three important outcomes of socialization. First, language skills. Secondly, political and religious beliefs and attitudes. Thirdly, the conception of self. The third core concern of the subject is the impact of individuals on group. Just as any group influences its members, these members in turn influence the group itself in terms of group productivity and decision making. Some members may contribute to leadership, performing functions such as planning, organizing, and controlling, which impacts the group performance. Without effective group leadership and coordination among group members, the group will drift or fail. Furthermore, individuals and minority coalitions often innovate change in group structure and procedures. Both leadership and innovation depend on the initiative, insight, and risk-taking ability of individuals. The fourth core concern of the subject is the impact of groups on groups. The fourth concern of social psychology is the impact of one group on the activities and structure of another group. Relations between two groups may be friendly or hostile, cooperative or competitive. These relationships, which are based in part on group members' identities, may entail group stereotypes which can affect the structure and activities of each group. Of special interest is the intergroup conflict, its tension and hostility. Violence may flare up, for instance, between racial or regional groups competing for scarce jobs. Conflicts of this type affect the interpersonal relations between groups and within each group also. Social psychologists have long studied the emergence, persistence, and resolution of intergroup conflicts. Even though social psychologists realize that we do not exist in isolation from social and cultural influences, the focus of the subject is strongly on individuals. Social psychologists are primarily interested in understanding the many factors that shape social behavior and thought of individuals, that is, that influence their actions, feelings, beliefs, memories, and inferences concerning other people. A large number of variables play a role in this regard and broadly fall under five major headings as described below. The factors that shape the social behavior and thought of individuals are biological factors, cognitive processes, social interactions, environmental and cultural variables. Let us look at the biological factors. Many social psychologists have come to believe that our preferences, behaviors, emotions, and even attitudes are affected to some extent by our biological inheritance. This view that biological factors play an important role in social behavior comes from the field of evolutionary psychology. Evolutionary psychology is a branch of psychology that suggests that our species, like all the others, has been subjected to the processes of biological evolution throughout its history. That as a result of this process, we now possess a large number of evolved psychological mechanisms that help us to deal with important problems related to survival. These mechanisms become a part of our biological inheritance through the process of evolution, which in turn involves three basic components. First, variation, second, inheritance, and finally, selection. Variation refers to the fact that human beings vary in many different ways and countless dimensions. Inheritance refers to the fact that some of these variations can be passed on from one generation to the next through complex mechanisms. Selection refers to the fact that some variations give individuals an upper hand in terms of reproduction and pass these variations on to the next generation. Social psychologists who adopt the evolutionary perspective suggest that this process applies to at least some aspects of social behavior, like helping others, aggression, preference in food habits, way of dressing, and selecting a partner. However, the evolutionary perspective does not suggest that we inherit specific patterns of social behavior. Rather, it contends that we inherit tendencies or predispositions that may or may not be apparent in our overt actions, depending on the environment in which we live. Similarly, this perspective does not suggest that we are forced or driven by our genes to act in specific ways. Rather, it merely suggests that because of our genetic inheritance, we have tendencies to behave in certain ways. These tendencies can be and often are overridden by cognitive factors and the effects of learning and experience. Secondly, cognitive processes influence social behavior and thought of a person. A person's reaction in a particular situation depends strongly on the memories of the past and inferences about others' behavior. For example, if you have arranged to meet a friend of yours and he or she turns up very late, our reaction will be based on his or her behavior in the past and the explanation that they give. Cognitive processes play a crucial role in social behavior and social thought. We are always trying to make sense out of the social world, and this leads us to engage in a lot of social cognition, that is, to think long and hard about other people, what they are like, why do they do what they do, and how they might react to our behavior, and so on. Therefore, social cognition is one of the most important areas of research in the field. Thirdly, let us look at social interactions. Actions of others definitely have an impact on our behavior and thought. Hundreds of instances occurring each day indicate that others' behaviors often has a powerful impact on us. For example, when we see a traffic police controller pulling up a driver for driving in the wrong direction, we immediately get cautioned and avoid taking that direction and drive in the right way. In addition, we are also affected by other people's appearance. We tend to behave differently towards old people compared to the young ones, towards people who belong to racial or an ethnic group different from our own. Research findings indicate that we cannot ignore the appearance of other people even when we consciously try to do so. The fourth impact is of the environmental and cultural variables. Research findings indicate that the physical environment does indeed influence our feelings, thoughts, and behavior. Social behavior and social thought are strongly influenced by the actions or characteristics of the people around us, but they do not occur in a cultural vacuum. On the contrary, our relations with others and how we think about them are often affected by events, beliefs, and trends of our own culture. For instance, in the past, people dressed in a certain way when they attended a party or dined in a fine restaurant. Men and women dressed formally. However, in the present times, many people dress casually in these settings. This attitude towards casual dressing has not progressed in all cultures. For instance, in Europe and many Asian countries, casual dressing is still not accepted in these settings. Social psychology certainly has some features of science. The first feature is reliance on empirical observation and classification of facts. The field comprises many thousands of empirical studies and clearly classified facts. Secondly, it relies on widely shared methodological procedures for conducting empirical investigation. Among the most widely employed methods in social psychology are experimentation and systematic sample surveys. The third feature is the accumulation of observed facts. Social psychologists continue to gather facts regarding the conditions under which specific behaviors occur. Though more is known about some types of behaviors than others, sophisticated studies have continued to expand the frontiers of knowledge. The fourth factor is reliance on theory. Although social psychology has no single unified theory covering all phenomena in the field, it does have several theoretical perspectives. It also has numerous middle-range theories that make predictions regarding specific types of social behavior under restricted conditions. After attaining a reasonable level of development, any science provides some degree of prediction and control with respect to the phenomena investigated in it. Although social psychology does fairly well in explaining social behavior, that is, identifying the conditions under which various forms of social behavior occur, it does not excel in predicting future events or providing a basis for the control of behavior. Any science is based on the principle of determinism. It assumes that the world is organized in terms of cause and effect. Although the assumption of determinism works well for many physical phenomena, it may not work well with human social behavior. Because human beings are conscious and self-aware, they can exercise some control over their own behavior. Unlike atoms or rocks, they are capable of making decisions and suddenly changing their behavior according to their own free will. Therefore, it is difficult to reconcile the scientific assumption of determinism with the concept of human free will. This concern is not unique to social psychology alone, but besets all social sciences. Social psychology bears a close relationship to several other fields, especially sociology and psychology. Sociology is the scientific study of human society. Sociology examines social institutions such as family, religion, politics, stratification within society, that is, class structure, race and ethnicity, and gender roles, basic social processes such as socialization, deviance and social control, and finally the structure of social units, that is, groups, networks, formal organizations, and bureaucracies. In contrast, psychology is the scientific study of the individual and of individual behavior. Although this behavior may be social in character, it need not be. Psychology addresses topics such as human learning, perception, memory, intelligence, emotion, motivation, and personality. Social psychology bridges sociology and psychology. In fact, some view it as an interdisciplinary field. Both sociologists and psychologists have contributed to social psychological knowledge. Social psychologists working in the sociological tradition rely primarily on sample surveys and observational techniques to gather data. These investigators are most interested in the relationship between individuals and the groups to which they belong to. Social psychologists emphasize such processes such as socialization, conformity and deviation, social interaction, self-presentation, leadership, recruitment to membership, cooperation and competition. Social psychologists working in the psychological tradition rely heavily on laboratory experimental methodology. Their primary concern is how an individual's behavior and internal states are affected by social stimuli, often by other persons. They emphasize such topics as the self, person perception and attribution, attitudes and attitude change, personality differences in social behavior, social learning and modeling, altruism and aggression, and interpersonal attraction. Thus, sociologically oriented and psychologically oriented social psychologists differ in their outlook and emphasis. Thus, this leads them to formulate different theories to conduct different programs of research. However, these differences are best viewed as complementary rather than as conflicting. Therefore, social psychology as a field is richer because of differing contributions of both the approaches.